just about set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. USC is lined up for the opening kickoff, so here we go. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Brought down at the 25. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. He's tackled at the 33-yard line. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Fires complete over the middle, and he's taken down at the 47-yard line.
That was a really nice play on the ball by the receiver for a substantial gain and a first down. Is important, but just as important as having receivers that can make plays.
From the 29-yard line, it's first down. Handoff up the middle. He's at the 20. He gets out to about the 17-yard line, and that's their third first down of the drive.
The defense needs to figure out a way to stop them, or else they're going to have no problem putting points on the board.
Fires quickly to the tight end. He's got it. Touchdown.
Give each of these guys credit for getting in sync, really fighting to create that touchdown.
And he hits the PAT. A nice five-play, 75-yard drive. And it's good for 7 points.
You know, when you can throw the football as well as these guys can, you don't necessarily always have to have a balanced attack because you're so proficient at throwing the ball.
Looks like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. USC's offense, a lot of times they can spread things out and they can really be versatile offensively, but when you've got a wide receiver like this, it really helps the cause.
It does, and it continues to help with what they're trying to do. They're trying to find matchups, and when you have one player like this that the defense has got to be aware of, they're going to spread you out, try to find a one-on-one matchup, and if you spend too much time with this one player, they've got some other weapons to make you pay for it.
Second and 10. Ball on the 25.
Here we go. Red 18. Red.
Quick throw out to the receiver. Brought down at about the 31. First down. He takes it right side for a good game.
That makes it second and six.
It out to about the 44-yard line. And Once again, they'll come to the line trying to convert on third down. Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry.
And it's picked up by one of the linemen.
Get on,
get on,
get on. We got it.
Gains his way to the 33-yard line.
That's another first down, Brad. Right now, you can just really feel and sense the rhythm that this offense is in. Their ability to pick up first downs, just pushing this defense further and further down, back deep into their own territory.
First and 10, ball on the 33. Rid of this one.
Great job by the defense at getting after that quarterback, and right now I think they've got him with some happy feet. He appears to be a bit rattled.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive. He's taken down right around the 30. Well, they'll line it up again on third down. Two for two so far on this drive. Scrambling around. And down he goes at the 21-yard line. This is the 11th play of this drive. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 22-yard line. And they get him in the backfield for a loss.
You know, when you feel pressure like that, the worst thing you want to do is just to throw the ball into coverage. He got away with one right there. He's very fortunate. Next time, he should just throw it away out of bounds.
Play 13 of the current drive.
Here we go.
Got his man. Can't tack out any yardage. It'll be short of the first after the completion.
Well, good effort by the defense to make sure they got him before he got to the marker.
So the field goal unit is on the field. They'll try for 3 points. The kick is up,
and he got it.
They line up to kick this one away. He just drills this one. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Brad, let's see if this offense can maintain the rhythm that they established on that last drive. Not just putting points on the board, but driving the length of the field to be able to eventually put points up. I think that's going to be important for them to try to keep that confidence going here on this drive.
Gets to about the 27-yard line. From their own 27-yard line. Second down. Oh, we had a pitcher's duel in that low-scoring first quarter. The Broncos lead it by 4. And we're back for more action here in quarter number 2. Boise State is up 4. Fires out quickly to the tailback. They'll bring him down at about the 33-yard line. It's third down, and they're about 2 yards shy of the sticks. He fights forward to about the 33. He really got a hold of that one. the 31-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way. And a quick throw. Tackle at about the 39-yard line.
The receiver found a hole in the zone and turned it into a first down.
No matter what type of defensive coverage you have, there are always going to be holes. The best thing you can do is make those holes small so the quarterback can't get the ball in there.
Now it's first and 10 after the big pass play. Completely stopped immediately.
That'll make a second and seven.
Has some daylight. He gets to about the 27-yard line. From the 27-yard line, first down. First and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line.
Perfect play call. They look like they practiced that one a few times.
Trying to go up by three. They'll kick the extra point. He splits the uprights with the extra point. So that's a five-play, 68-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the offense did a really nice job of mixing up the play calling on that drive. I thought the defense was on its heels most of the drive because of the versatility of the offense.
The score now, 10-7. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. They try to get a head start there.
False start. Offense.
Sometimes what happens on a false start is a lineman will see movement on the other side of the ball and be coaxed into jumping early.
So we'll have first and 15 after the penalty. And he's tackled at the 22. The running back gets 2 on the carry.
You have to like how this linebacker was able to move up quickly and bring down the ball carrier for a short gain. Nice stop by the junior.
So an empty backfield with 5 wide receivers. Complete. He's got room. He's tackled around the 38-yard line. From their own 38-yard line, it's first down. Gains his way to the 49-yard line.
The offensive coordinator has to be elated with the way his offense right now is executed. They're not in a hurry, but they're very, very methodical and very consistent with their approach. That's a third first down that they've picked up on this drive.
Quick throw, incomplete, one of his receivers.
This is a well-designed play by the offensive coordinator. Everything really seemed to be working just fine, except for the quarterback. He's got to throw a better football.
From the 49-yard line, second down. Pass
passes to the left, and it's going the other way. Great catch by the linebacker, but not a smart throw from the quarterback.
It didn't look like the quarterback even saw the linebacker hanging in that area. It pays to be in the right spot at the right time.
USC holds a field goal lead. Under pressure. Quick out to his receiver. That's a great tackle at the 24-yard line. About 2 minutes before halftime. Play fake, looking to run. Decides to slide. About 9 yards there on the quarterback scramble. USC is going to use their first time out of the half here. No good. Short yardage situation here. It's third and one. Hand off and he won't make it. It's up, and they tack on 3 points. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Give to the tailback. And they'll get him in the backfield. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 25-yard line.
Receiver, but it's a nice gain of 5.
He chucks it downfield. This one will fall incomplete.
Brady drops the ball here. I don't know if he's starting to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
The defense looks like they're going to send in the cavalry on this one. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. Down at the 34. So we've played two quarters. The Trojans in front, 13-7. All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here.
Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. And here we go with the offense, ready to get things going again. USC up six. They'll give it off here. And he's taken down around the 39-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 39.
Here we go.
Just throws this one away. We've got third and 10, ball on the 39-yard line. He's got to throw it in a hurry. Going deep. Oh, boy, almost intercepted. This one is a beauty. From the 15. And he's taken down at the 23-yard line. There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. Decent run here, right side. Yards away here on second down. On the throw, incomplete pass. Shot to the open receiver, and he can't hang on to the ball.
That makes it fourth and four.
It's away, and it's a booming punt. Gets out to about the 31. We're about set to start things up again. USC with a six-point lead. Right down around the 37-yard line.
That'll bring up second and three.
They need about 3 yards to get the first here on second down. And they make the stop at the 36.
There, making it look so easy.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 42. Makes the catch and look out. Tackle made at midfield.
Number 13. That makes it second and two.
It's second down, and they're about 2 yards away from the sticks. Here's the give. He's taken down at the 49-yard line.
That play was over before it got started. That was just a case of the offensive line getting beat at the snap of the ball.
USC is up by 6. He makes it out to maybe the 49-yard line. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. And down he goes, right around the 46-yard line. So that 3-yard scamper by the halfback is good for the first down.
That's another rush from this halfback. This time he does a great job of finding the opening in the defense and picking up the first down.
5 wide. And he throws it away. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. And he's tackled in the open field. It's first and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. They come out in a 5-wide set. Looks for his tight end over the middle. Good tackle there in space. This is the 11th play of this drive. From the 24-yard line, it's second down. Throws complete. He's got space to work. And that sets them up for the first and goal.
That makes it first and goal.
It's first down, and they'll be looking for 6 points here. USC up 6. Touchdown, USC!
A powerful push by the line and a really nice run. That'll get you into the end zone almost every time.
He tacks on the extra point. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He just drills this one. He's to the 20. Gets out to about the 21.
USC's the type of team, when you look at them, it looks like their defense sort of just feeds off itself.
I think the energy is there, Brad, but I think it really starts up front with their defensive line and their linebackers. The way they're being able to just win the battle at the line of scrimmage, I think it's giving them confidence, and it's allowing them to play more downhill where they can attack this offense.
Strike to his receiver, no good. It's second and 10. Ball on the 21-yard line. Throws out to the back, and he can't hold out. And gets out of bounds.
He showed you right there why a defense can never lose tabs on it. Take your eye off him in coverage, and he'll create a big play.
from their own 41-yard line. First down. He's got it out to his tight end. Tackle at the 46. They spread the field in the gun with five wide receivers. Caught with room to work. He gets hit out of bounds at the 30. So with one quarter remaining, the Trojans lead 20-7. Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. He's at the 20. And he's pushed out of bounds, setting up a first and goal. First down, and they've got their eyes on that goal line. Touchdown, Broncos!
He just put his eyes on that end zone and ran with some real purpose there.
He makes the PAT. A nice seven-play, 78-yard drive. And they add 7 points to the scoreboard. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. And he got all of this one. Great kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Both teams realize that when the ball is snapped, we're one play away from a very different ballgame. USC with a six-point lead. Couldn't hang on here in the fourth quarter. Second and 10. Ball on the 25. They'll bring him down right around the 36-yard line. Rid of this one. From their own 36-yard line, it's second down. And a nice catch there before he stepped out of bounds. His way to about the 32. We've got a first and 10. Ball on the 32-yard line. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
With the carry. That's good for a gain of 5 yards. That brings up second and five.
USC is up by six.
Here we go.
Nice run, and he's brought down. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. tailback, and he's hit immediately for a loss.
Think about the speed and instincts it takes for a linebacker to get from his position into the backfield to make a play like that. That's well done.
10th play of the drive. Makes it out to about the 7.
That's the 5th first down for this offense on this drive. The defense, you can look at it. Their hands are on their knees, hands are on their hips. They're looking tired. This offense right now has this defense exactly where they want it.
Touchdown, Southern Cal. And they're looking to get 2 points here. The play clock's at 0. They took too much time.
Delay of game. Offense.
That penalty drives them back, and they're shooting themselves in the foot here.
Well, if they could just keep their concentration, they'll avoid situations like that.
And they won't get the 2. Looks like they're ready for the kick. Excellent kick. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
Brad, this is my kind of game. I love seeing this kind of production and the way these quarterbacks are playing. Both teams are challenging both of these defenses.
The offense will be hoping they can move the ball as well as they did on their last drive. Just under 2 to go in the game. Quick throw, knocked out of bounds at the 37. First and 10, ball on the 37-yard line. He chucks it downfield. Incomplete, almost picked off.
Well, you want to do everything you can to keep the ball out of the hands of these receivers, so that was a really good effort. Efficient play call. You don't need to make the highlight reel on each play.
There's a strike complete. So it's 2nd and 10. Ball on the 50-yard line. Goes out of bounds, right around the 42-yard line.
it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down.
Just over a minute left.
And he's tackled at the 33. At the 20, and he's taken down at the 14-yard line.
The Broncos use their second timeout.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Wants to throw outside. Incomplete pass.
But he must have hurried there because his receiver was wide open. There was no need to rush that one at all.
From the 14-yard line, second down. He's in trouble. He's got a touchdown. PAT.
So a 12-play, 77-yard drive, and they put up 7 points.
Brad, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow him down.
And he's tackled at the 40-yard line.
This is where the offense has to come to the forefront. They work all week for situations like this. They've got the lead. They've got a chance to add to it, and that would mean a victory.
He takes a knee.
Boise State's called their final timeout. It's second and 12. Ball on the 43-yard line. We have less than a minute to go.
If you're an offensive coordinator, you love this play. His quarterback will take a knee.
Trojans coaching staff, Kirk, do they start wondering, hey, are we going to have trouble with our star player after the struggles he had today?
Well, I think the coaching staff's got to be happy that this team is able to win the football game and overcome the fact that their star player didn't have a great game. But I think making adjustments and changing the game plan because their star didn't deliver, I think that would be a big mistake.
That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.